apa yang kalau macam untuk parents yang jarang ataupun tak pernah buat ataupun dia cuba nak buat tapi dia tak tahu macam mana nak expect, how to expect and respond diorang kan. Diorang kan tak nak dengar, diorang berbual kan. Tapi mungkin boleh nasihatkan untuk yang mereka yang nak cuba buat tapi yeah, what can they expect lah bagi parents?
I know it's hard. Okay, as a parent, nak mainkan peranan tu, kita lah ustaz dia, kita lah ustazah dia, kita tukang masak dia, rebar dia semua. I know it's hard. Okay, to me, okay, frankly speaking, duha tu, it's really hard kalau it's just involving my children. So what we did masa duha, kita panggil lah geng-geng yang dia punya BFF. Kan dia suka jumpa macam kita juga kan, suka jumpa kawan kan. So lepas balik sekolah tu kita okay come to my house, okay. So it's like a playtime learning. Dia tak, bukanlah kita duduk sini baca satu ayat tak, okay. So dia main-main dia okay. Lepas tu kita katalah nak tak kita sit down. Kita ceritalah macam orang tua kan, kita tahu macam majlis ilmu, ada malaikat. So we read the hadis, kita kata hilah malaikat pun nak join kita. Okay, they say to each other, hilah ku zikri, there's a majlis ilmu. Okay, so kita nak surrounded by malaikat. So we fascinate them. Okay, dengan benda-benda stories which is the authentic story from Quran. Lepas tu kita ceritalah kalau kita baca ni satu huruf Allah bagi 10 pahala. So kita ulang dengan friends ni. The more children around you dan kita orang Islam, that's the word from my head teacher lah. Dia kata, no, it's okay. And invite all the Malaysians semua. The more the merrier. So I was like, kalau kita orang Melayu ni macam, serabut. Betul tak? So, saya memang pegang lah dekat kata-kata guru besar saya dekat UK dulu. Dia kata the more the merrier. So saya fikir pula, kita satu budak tu 10 malaikat jaga kan. So kalau lagi ramai budak, insyaAllah kita yang tua yang banyak dosa, budak tak dosa kan, lagi dapat dinaungi pada malaikat. So it's like a fun learning yang dia tak formal kan. So kalau kita pergi nak pergi playground dengan kawan-kawan kan, seronok kan. Okay, jom sambil tu dalam kereta kita main quiz, kita ulang-ulang secara tak sengaja. Okay, dekat UK I apply singing and sign sebab bukan special needs. Dia tak ada sekolah special needs. Kakak Malaysia ni special needs jom dengan rakan-rakan special needs kan. So kita singing and sign. So dalam tasmi ni bila QST, Quran Story Time, I do lots of signing. So dia boleh attract lah budak tu punya attention sebenarnya. Okay, so saya nak ajar lah satu and we sing. Okay, ada hadis Rasulullah SAW, khairukum. Okay, boleh ikut saya?
Boleh, okay. Boleh.
Okay, remember your children. Okay, so let's repeat after me. Khairukum.
Khairukum.
Man ta'allama al-Quran.
Man ta'allama al-Quran.
Okay, let's repeat from the beginning. Khairukum.
Man ta'allama al-Quran.
Al-Quran. Okay, wa'allamahu. So, if you, kita baca macam tu je, jadi macam agak-agak ter-attract. Saya rasa Ustaz Dayak seorang je yang ter-attract dengan apa yang saya kan. Okay, so, okay, ready? Khair, show me your finger, thumbs up.
Okay.
So it'll be of Arabic lah. Okay. So Rasulullah SAW said, khairukum, the best among you. So you move your thumbs up and khairukum man. Khairukum man. Okay. So who is the best person Rasulullah SAW said is the one who ta'allama al-Quran.
Ta'allama al-Quran.
Okay. Khairukum man ta'allama al-Quran. Okay, and then
ta'allama al-Quran. Okay.
We learn Quran, the best, or as I said, the best among you is the one who learn Quran. We are learning Quran, and what we have to do next? Wa'allamahu.
Wa'allamahu. Baginya.
Yeah. Have to teach others. So you're gonna be the best person in the whole universe.
Di luar sana banyak orang yang mungkin seperti saya, seperti Syahib ke apa kan, jadi macam bila nak start storytelling rasa macam lemau gitu, macam lemah aje, macam malas gitu. Ada tak macam tips ke, macam memang kita nak kena lawan juga ke macam mana?
Dia macam sembang macam kawan kan, kalau macam ustaz jumpa dengan Syahid macam, kau nak tahu apa macam macam tu lah, kita treat the children macam macam kawan kita kan. Sebab kita biasa dengan children ni, we have like a formal punya approach, betul tak? And okay. adults to a child. Tapi kita macam dekat UK, we've been trained to be, the word is silly. Okay, masukkan dalam otak, you have to act silly. Okay. Itu bukan budaya gila kita. When you act silly, you feel the children and they got attracted to you, insyaAllah. Budak ni dia ikhlas, dia tak ada dosa kan. Jadi macam kalau aku cakap dengan orang besar, macam alah dia ni pasal bagus. Tapi no children will do that to you kan, tak ada. Jadi the first thing is to be silly. Okay. Number two is have lots of empathy. Kita downgrade diri kita. Okay. Macam Rasulullah SAW, saya peganglah dekat kisah yang mana sahabat dia tangkap budak musyrikin tu kan. Lepas tu dia tanya, berapa tentera yang kau ada? Berapa tentera kan? So that little child, he couldn't answer. Sampai sahabat pukul. Bila Rasulullah SAW dengar, bagi dia terus pergi dekat tempat budak tu lah dan tanya sahabat, kenapa sampai kau kena pukul? So macam this is empathy kan, of course lah. Jadi Rasulullah SAW tunjukkan kita, a little child, kau cakap tentera, bukan dia faham pun. So macam mana Rasulullah SAW menyantuni anak-anak, he just twist the question. Berapa unta yang kau nampak? So antara nak cerita pasal empathy ni kan, so Rasulullah SAW downgraded, he's the best man in the whole universe, but he downgraded himself untuk otak budak kecil-kecil kot kan, antara tentera dengan camel, unta, okay. Mana agak-agak yang budak-budak lagi suka nak cakap, lagi macam tertarik macam tu lah.